All right, welcome. I'm KCRA 3 meteorologist Dirk Verdoorn, and going to do a little Facebook Live talking about the changes that we're expecting as we head through this coming week. And it is going to be pretty significant considering the nice weather that we've had through this weekend. We had temperatures ranging in the mid to low 70s both Saturday and Sunday. And that's going to come to an end. We'll start to see that change a little bit on Monday, and we'll continue to see those changes increasing as we head through the rest of the week and into next weekend. But let's go ahead and take a look at where we are right now as far as our weather pattern, what's going on. You can see pretty good the boundary. You can have the cloud cover that's coming up over and then diving down, so that's an area of high pressure. We have the high pressure that's in place over Sacramento. That's why we had temperatures so warm today. Cooler air coming in behind. In fact, the center of low pressure is centered, again, just right about in here. I kind of draw a little spiral, that hole, and that's gonna be sliding south. It's actually gonna set up shop off the coast of California and continue to throw clouds our way and the chance for rain our way. But until then, it's gonna be dry, at least through Monday. We'll start to see the chance for rain coming in by Tuesday, and we'll feel the influence of that cooler air. So future cast, let's take a look at what's gonna be going on as far as, again, kind of closer up here with cloud cover and where we're gonna see that chance for rain. Starting out along the northern coast as we get into Monday, we'll see that chance for rain. And here in the valley, I will have periods of clouds. It'll clear out. Here we are by Monday night. We should see some clearing, but then more cloud cover is gonna roll in as we go into Tuesday. And then expect to have conditions that are going to, again, we'll see those showers. So I'm gonna back up here around. Here we are, Tuesday morning. This is early, early morning. This is 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock. 3 o'clock, look at the showers that are popping up here, up and down the valley. So just very limited, very scattered, light showers, accumulations, not much, but there will be some areas of rain. And that will continue through the early morning hours, then dissipate some. Looks like we have a pulse that's gonna make its way up the west slope of the Sierra from Calaveras County North. A little bit of snow associated with that, but that should not give you any travel problems. This is going to be a fairly warm system, and so it does pack a lot more water vapor with it. That's going to bring about the better chance for some higher amounts of precipitation. But most of the energy is going to be north of San Francisco, so you can see that quite well. The heavier rain, the areas of darker green and yellow showing up through Lake County and points north is where we're going to see that. While we do have a few showers popping up in the Sierra, it's going to be limited and pushing off to the north. Now you can see all the active weather going on in coastal mountains and along the coast of California. You can see the rain over Yuba City. At this point here Tuesday at between 10 and 11 o'clock, we'll have that chance. Even Sacramento could see some rain from this, but then it starts to back off as we move from Tuesday into Wednesday. And we continue with that. There's Tuesday, and we get into Wednesday, and you can see some fog Wednesday morning from the rain and the clearing skies, cooler temperatures, and then more cloud cover rolls in as another wave of rain starts to develop along the coast of California. So this is where all the heaviest rain is going to stay, it looks like. So as far as accumulations go, again, we're limited. We're going to see a little bit in the valley, but the bulk of the rain will be along the coast. And you can see as we see those numbers just kind of tack up. Inch and a quarter possible at Lakeport, Fort Bragg over an inch, and you get up to Eureka, and we're talking about amounts that could be between an inch and a half to 2 inches of rainfall. So that's where we're going to see the significant rainfall from this system. Elsewhere, not a whole lot. We're looking at just a few hundreds here or there. And even in the Sierra, we're not going to see a whole lot of precipitation. This is through Tuesday. So again, that's just the Tuesday system. We'll see some more thrown in as we go through Wednesday and Thursday, and we'll see those numbers over the next several days. We'll see that developing. But looking at what's going on with the big picture here, here's Tuesday evening, area of low pressure off the coast of California. We're getting that southerly flow coming through. And the chance for rain looks like it's going to stay away through Wednesday morning, but then we get into Wednesday afternoon, and here comes another pulse of rain that's going to make its way through on Wednesday night and into Thursday morning, and then it backs off, and then we see another wave come through on into Thursday night and into Friday morning. And then it's really going to be, here's Saturday night, but Friday night, but as we get into Saturday, that's when we could see the best chance right now for more widespread, steadier rain. And here we are Saturday at 7 a.m. We'll get that rain and even a little bit of snow over the southern Sierra. But then that low finally kicks out. It finally moves off to the east. And as it does so, it's going to take that precipitation with it as we go through Saturday again late afternoon and into the evening hours. And then what takes this place is this ridge of high pressure. This high pressure then is going to, it looks like it could dominate our weather pattern as we go through the week of Thanksgiving. So that's great for folks that are going to be traveling. Looks like that should help to make it easier if you're going to be driving someplace. The only thing that'll be interesting to see is if we do see some fog start to develop in its way, because that usually this time of year, if we get a nice big ridge of high pressure over California and get calm conditions right here, we have enough wind. I don't think fog is going to be too much of a problem for sticking around. But if we get the center of this area of high pressure right over California, that's when we get into those situations where you get the inversion and you get the fog that sets up and just doesn't want to break. So right now that does not look like the case. In fact, what'll happen is if we do have any fog, it won't last very long, and temperature should warm up nicely as we go through the afternoons. So it'll be interesting to see just how warm our temperatures will get for the week of Thanksgiving. But right now, as we look at the 7-day forecast, you can see that we have that chance for rain. So that's really what is standing out this week as we go from our nice weather that we've had, still pretty nice on Monday, and it's still gonna be nice on Tuesday. But we will have that chance for rain. Again, from the midsection of the Sacramento Valley to the west is going to be your best bet. Northern Sierra could see some showers, but it's really the coastal areas and coastal mountains that'll see the bulk of the rain on Tuesday. Then just some scattered showers with waves on Wednesday and into Thursday. Better chance for rain moves in Friday, especially Friday night and into Saturday. And right now that looks like where we could get the bulk of our rain is during that time frame as the low moves over Northern California and clears out and heads east away from the state. And so that's kind of what we're going to be dealing with. You can see temperatures pretty close to average. I mean, not looking at a big cool down, but it will be much cooler than the temperatures that we have experienced. But overall, I mean, this is a pattern that's, I mean, to be honest, fairly typical for this time of year. Now, the cutoff low is not, but just getting that chance for rain, we need to start seeing that chance for rain developing. And hopefully we'll get some storms eventually that will push their way across the area, giving us not only some rain, but also bringing in some cooler temperatures and giving us some snow in the Sierra, setting things up for a nice winter season. So hopefully that'll be taking place. But right now it looks like after we get through this kind of unsettled period, it looks like we are going to have another dry spell with temperatures that could warm up. At least there's that potential right now. So that's what's going on. So plan accordingly. If you do have any outdoor activities planned this week, be prepared for the chance for some rain. Better chance if you want to get away from it would be to head south and to head east. So thanks for joining me, and hope you